smile, an everlasting smile. Her smile can bring you near to me. Don't ever let me find you down, 'cause that would bring a tear to me.
This world has lost its glory. Let's start a brand new story now, my love.
Right now, there'll be no other time, and I can show you how, my love. Talk in everlasting words and dedicate them all to me. And I will give you all my life. I'm here if you should call to me.
You think that I don't even mean a single word I say. It's only words,
and words are all I have to take your heart away.
It's only words, and words are all I have to take your heart away. It's only words,
and words are all I have to take your heart away.
Om Shanti. A very small boy once heard about God and he decided to go and meet God. But he did not know where to go, how to go. So one fine morning, he got up early in the morning, packed his bag, carried, he took few sandwiches, some biscuits, and started his journey to meet God. So that small boy reached a nearby garden. It was the morning time, and he saw that a woman is sitting there, an old woman. And he goes and sits near that woman. It's a time for breakfast. So he opens his sack, then tiffin, and starts eating. But he looks at that woman and he thinks that that woman perhaps is hungry. An old woman looks dejected. So he offered her a piece of sandwich and she smiled. And her smile was beautiful. The small boy was delighted to see that beautiful smile. Once that woman finished her sandwich, The boy offered her some biscuits, which she happily ate. And they kept on smiling, but there was no talk. Until evening they were together, enjoying each other's company. And when it was sunset, the boy went back home. As he was about to leave, he hugged her again, and they both parted. And the woman was very delighted, the old woman. The boy reached his home, and his mother asked him, "Where were you the whole day along?" The boy said, "Today I met God." And the smile of God was very beautiful, and enjoyed the company of God. The woman went home, and her grandson asked her, "Where were you the whole day along?" The grandmother said, "Today I met God." And his smile was very beautiful. And he is much younger than what I thought. So, two souls, they spent time together. And they enjoyed each other's company. And it was just the smile that brought them near. And they felt as if in that company they experienced the divine. They saw the reflection of the Supreme. So being close to each other and to experience the spiritual pleasure, that spiritual love, that spiritual feeling of belongingness, that spiritual intimacy, that spiritual closeness. And when you do this with the Supreme, the whole world is forgotten. This world has lost its glory. Let's start a brand new story. Smile, a smile can bring you near to me. Words and words, all that I have to take your heart away. So this world loses its glory, the attraction, the pomp, the temptations are all lost when we are in the company of the Supreme. So today is the great day in the lives of Brahmin souls, where we would be face to face with the Supreme. So how to be close to God, or being with God? Today we'll discuss something about this. How to be with Him, how to be close to Him, how we increase our nearness, our closeness, our intimacy with God. How can we live our lives in such a way that He is the perennial presence felt all the time? He is the divine, the eternal presence which would accompany us all the time. So that life is the life of pleasure, of happiness, when the divine, when the Supreme is with us all, at all time, in all the stations of life. Yesterday's Murli Baba said, Baba is the only refreshment. Baba is the only true refreshment. We had got tired in the path of devotion, lost in the cobweb of confusion, superstitions, lost in the cobweb of our own confused thinkings, lost in the cobweb of wandering, seeking refuge in human beings. And what was the result? Ultimately, we got tired. the spiritual fatigue, and that made us totally bankrupt. Now Baba has come, and he is the only refreshment, and he is the only true refreshment. And when he comes, the soul is recharged. Even there was one murli, Sakar Murli, where Baba had made a very strong dramatic statement. He said, even 1 minute of remembrance, true remembrance, can fill the soul with light and might. Just 1 minute. 1 minute of true remembrance can fill the soul with light and might. So, Baba is coming today, and we need to prepare ourselves for that great meeting. How to be with him all the time? To meet him once is not enough. We have to be in his company all the time. So how to increase the closeness, the nearness to him? This is a question everyone must ask to oneself. How should I remain close to him all the time? How should I remain in his company all the time? How can I experience his love, his support, his care, his canopy, his protection all the time? So, few things we can do in order to be in his company. First, talking with him. If we tell, do yoga, so yoga involves being bodiless, feel concentrated, and so many things. So yoga is a difficult term. You have to replace the difficult terms by some simpler words. So one of the methods of going close to God is talking with him. Just talking with him, pouring your heart out, telling him how much we miss him, telling him what happened when we went away from him. He is the supreme refreshment. He is the true refreshment. He is the only refreshment. No human being can ever refresh us. No worldly thing, object, place, relationship can ever refresh us. Soul is refreshed. Soul is brought alive. Soul is recharged. Soul is empowered only and only by his company. So one of the methods of going very close to him is talking with him. Second, sharing with him. Sharing with him everything, whatever is on your mind. Sharing all the life experiences, sharing the slightest of the emotion that arose in the heart. Sharing each and every event. Sharing things, ordinary life events. Sharing the past. Sharing the future anxieties. Sharing the present. So sharing with him almost everything. That will make the soul, that will enable the soul to go near to God. So talking with him, sharing with him, walking with him. Walk with him all the time, as if his hand is in my hand. I am not walking alone. He is always with me. Even in the remotest of places, even in the most lonely places, I am not alone. But he is accompanying me. I am in his company. He is my supreme companion. I am in the supreme company of the supreme. So walking with him all the time. Singing with him. Sing the songs with him. Make him your singing partner. You sing one word, one line, and he sings the other line. You know, there are duets. Two singers sing together. So you can sing one thing and let him sing another. So make him your singing partner. Then dance with him. We have Gyan dance. We have the dance of knowledge. So make him your dancing partner. Whenever you feel like to dance, invoke him, call him, ask him to join you. This is the spiritual dance. The worldly dance is danger, Baba said once upon a time. It's very dangerous. This is a spiritual dance. This is the dance of ecstasy. This is the dance of rapture. This is the dance of happiness. This is the dance of spiritual bliss. This is the dance of bodilessness. This is the dance where you forget yourself and your being gets merged in the being of Supreme. You and he become one. Once Michael Jackson had said somewhere that when I dance, a stage comes when dancer and dancing becomes one. And I don't realize what is happening. Even the worldly souls, when they enter or they get drowned in some activity, they transcend the body and they enter the bodiless stage for a few seconds. And they enjoy that ecstasy. So this is the dance of Gyan. This is the dance of joy. So dance with him. Then sleep with him. Be with him in his divine protection. Yesterday's Murli Baba said, one of the methods of refreshment is Baba's lap. Go and sleep in his lap. This is an experiment one can do when you get tired doing the day's work. In the evening yoga, you can begin with this. As if I am sleeping in the lap of God. As if I am reclining, resting, and he is keeping his hand on my forehead. And I am feeling relieved now. All the fatigue, all the tiredness, all the exhaustion is gone. So sleeping with him, sleeping in his lap. Then, being close to God means experiencing his canopy, Chhatra Chaya, as if his canopy is ever with me. Wherever I am going, the canopy is above me. Wherever I move, his canopy protects me. And it is his words that I am your protector. Yogakshemam vahamyaham. I will take care of you. I will take care of your every need, your every want, your every privation. It's my responsibility. So wherever you go, wherever we go, his protection, his shade, his canopy, his mantle protects us. So enjoying his canopy all the time. In the moments of fear, in the moments of insecurity, or even gross darkness, one is walking alone and there is nobody on the road. And it's the dark hours of night. Feel, imagine his canopy is protecting me. Then bathing in the fountain of his love. Fountain of Baba's love. So as if there is a fountain. When I am here, and all the rays of bliss, happiness, pleasure, love, everything is falling upon me, and I am enjoying the fountain of His love. So His love is upon me all the time. Wherever I am going, you know, there was one video in between somebody had sent. It was very funny. It was very hot weather and somebody was carrying water cylinder, and it was like pouring all the town fountain on the head to keep the head cool. Have you seen that? It's quite funny. He was carrying a cylinder of water and it's so hot and that is continuously pouring here. He's moving along. Yeah. That for spraying insecticides, you have a cylinder there. So he had a cylinder back and it was constantly pouring here to keep, and he was bald and it was keeping his head cool. So you can carry this fountain of divine love, and that is continuously pouring light, water of God's love. So, then, writing to Him, write down, almost every day, write a letter to Him. One letter a day is one of the best practices. One letter a day. If you see the lives of saints, Saint Francis, Saint Assisi, Saint Bernard, all the Roman Catholic saints, they used to write letter. Saint Bernard of Clairvaux, if you read his letters, they are filled with God's love. They are describing the agony of separation. How we are away from you, where are you, O Lord, O Lord, O Lord. So writing a letter, how many letters? One letter a day, almost every day. That should turn into a book by the end of the year. Okay, otherwise Baba says just write chart. Okay, you can write one, okay. But I'm not talking of writing, okay. Describe everything. It's as if a diary. So you can convert it, take a diary and write every night everything that has happened to you. Start with Baba, comma, and start narrating. I woke up at this time, then I went to the class, then I met that person, then this happened, then that happened. Then we went to Madhuban and we had 6 days in Madhuban, and then we came back and now I am here. Write the name of place, date, time. 3 things in the diary and write down everything. So this is the spiritual diary. This is the spiritual diary. So one must maintain a spiritual diary. That will be a communion with God. That will be as if we are with Him. So, being with Him is a very good thing. And increase that company more and more. Praise Him, compliment Him, thankful, express your thankfulness to Him. These are some other things which we can do. You can also complain. You can also complain. And try to be with Him in order to understand Him. Because you can understand any person only if you stay with Him. So you can, if you want to understand God, you will have to stay with Him. Then only you will get to know His nature, His likes, His dislikes. What He loves, what He doesn't love. What are His hobbies? Hobbies of God. Likes of God, what He loves to eat, what He doesn't love to eat, what He loves to see and what He doesn't love to see, everything. So make Him a person, making a living presence. In Bible there is one statement, we live, we move, we have our being in Him. We live, we move, we have our being in Him. He is our everything. He is our be all and end all. He is the Alpha and the Omega of the world. He is the beginning, the middle and the end of the world. Aham Adishya Madhyasya. I am everything. In a Gita, God says, Arjuna, just listen what I am telling you. Whatever that exists in this world, I am the support of that. everything that exists in the world. So, he is everything. He is all in all. Sarve sarva. He is everything. So, be in his company. So, talk with him. Sing with him. Dance with him. Write to him. Be in his company. Experience his canopy. Experience his shade. Be under the fountain of his love. And dance, sing, move around, sleep, everything. Eat with him that day. As I said, telling last 2-3 days, eat with me. Don't eat alone. So eating with him, sleeping with him, everything. So make him your intimate partner of life. And when I forget that God is my supreme partner, when I forget that God is my supreme companion, I feel extremely lonely. That's the only point when I feel lonely. And loneliness attracts Maya. And loneliness is a gateway to vices, restlessness. When we are occupied, when we are busy, Maya may not trouble us. But the moment we are alone, Maya attacks. And we are caught unawares. So today is a great day for all the Brahmins. So throughout the day, maintain that inner silence, inner solitude, inner introspection, introversion, retrospection, and be in his company, enjoying his divine, supreme, invisible, impalpable, and yet palpable presence. Om Shanti.
Smile, an everlasting smile, a smile can bring you near to me. Don't ever let me find you down, 'cause that would bring a tear to me.
This world has lost its glory, let's start a brand new story now. My love,
right now, there'll be no other time, and I can show you how. My love, talk in everlasting words, and dedicate them all to me. And I will give you all my life. I'm here if you should call to me.
You think that I don't even mean a single word I say. It's only words,
and words are all I have to take your heart away.
It's only words,
and words are all I have to take your heart away.
It's only words,
and words are all I have to take your heart away.